how a knot practice evolves or may evolve, right? So I, as you may, many of you know, I did my undergrad in Argentina at the Instituto Universitario Nacional del Arte, and I did my frameworks and theories, and it can take, you know, different forms. But I guess one that is interesting to inquire for me has to do with space. And I think we might have talked about this in class, but like we enter a space and there's certain configurations of space that we maybe usually take for granted, right? So we enter this room and we know that there's a chair exposed in a certain way, and that we're going to sit. And that was my work. I wish I had done that, you know. And it happens because we've talked about also in lectures, like, these are things that are out there, and as artists we kind of grab them and we materialize them in different ways. So there's that fine line between looking at something and sort of reproducing it without necessarily creating or problematizing that, and maybe looking at something and from there sort of building on and continue to build up on that research, right? And there's many different ways to do that. Yeah, so I think that is kind of a pretty good summary of what my practice is about. Another thing that I've been thinking a lot lately, and mostly being in the MFA program here, because as much as in your undergrad program here, you know, you are required to work conceptually and research, etc. The MFA is kind of totally shaping culture in different ways, right? So, if we understand our language as a way through which we understand the world, as even thinking how there's languages that don't necessarily make a difference between gender, like there's some languages that maybe don't have he or she. You know, how does that determine how we understand each other or ourselves? In what ways do we think that language can alter or can determine the way in which we inhabit space? So, there's one of the words that is on the slideshow, but there's it's like a door and it says, this is not a space, it is